They're undoubtedly wondering the very thing I was wondering at exactly this time in my life. Well, everybody now is wondering, when will the pandemic be behind us? But the question that's more immediately in front of them is, what should I be doing? Like, I'm going to law school. You know, I know there are lots of courses you can take and services people want to sell you, but we have kind of a different perspective on that. So tell people what they should be doing right now if they're headed to law school in the next few weeks.
Well, congratulations, and it's going to be super exciting. And you know, it's a lot of work, of course, but almost everyone, there's always tough parts of first year because there's a lot of pressure, but almost everyone I ever talk to thinks fondly of their first year of law school because it is this amazing experience. And so you're going to be knee deep in cases and law, and some people suggest, well, you know, you should sort of like brush up in advance, you know, read a like a mini torts treatise or a contracts treatise. I think I wouldn't do that. You're going to learn law in law school. It's not going to help you much. You're not going to get that much out of it, probably, to be reading substantive law. Read our book because it is designed now really to help you ease into law school and to explain to you everything from the mundane, like, hey, maybe you should check the calendar, which I didn't do when I was a first year law student, and see, you know, how long the semester is and when are exams going to be, and sort of start counting backwards and just make some tentative plans about how you're going to do things. So it's very mundane, but there's also, as you said, some introduction to legal vocabulary and the kind of structure of the legal system that I think will serve students in good stead in terms of orienting them. So read our book, read the newspaper or go to a news website. Law is a practical discipline. There's some great theoretical questions, including the ultimate question of what is law anyway? And Lord knows I love thinking about that question, but at the end of the day, lawyers are practical people. They're worried about things in the world. They're worried about, can I get someone to sign a waiver of liability for COVID if I'm infected in a restaurant? And will a judge enforce that waiver? Well, that's a legal question, but it's a very practical question too. And so everything you read about in the news sooner or later will matter to your legal thinking and legal studies. So pay attention to the world. And maybe have a little fun too. And you could even have some law-related fun, if yes, there are such things. Could be in the form of a movie or a TV show. There are some obviously fun, kind of goofy takes on law school. Legally Blonde is a classic. But there's a range of depictions of lawyers, Better Call Saul. You can find them. That none of them are realistic, but they wouldn't be that interesting if they were realistic. They're just kind of fun, exaggerated takes on the practice of law. There's also more serious materials. There's a great documentary called Loving on the famous constitutional case, Loving versus Virginia, which, believe it or not, in 1964, that late, recognized the constitutional right to marry a person of a different race. And it's an amazing documentary about the couple and their legal battles. So there's a range of materials, but I wouldn't get too heavy at this point. You'll be plenty busy in a few weeks.
Yeah, though I do want to underscore, because people going to law school they're excited to go to law school and maybe a little nervous about it. You could watch that classic, The Paper Chase, to get the sense of what law school might once have been. But there's a lot of good stuff about the law. You mentioned Legally Blonde. I think one of my favorite fun movies about the law is My Cousin Vinny. But there are, as we've discussed, there's documentaries about Ruth Bader Ginsburg and her crusade for women's equality. There's the documentary 13 about sort of what's gone wrong with race and policing in the country and incarceration. And there's just a range of wonderful materials about the law, whatever interests you. Again, if you're, I'm focused very much on policing and Michelle Alexander's wonderful book, The New Jim Crow, very troubling but important to read. So I think I echo your view that if you're hungry for law, there are plenty of places to find it in ways that don't involve trying to learn law before going to law school. What's the point of doing that?
Thanks for tuning into the show. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already to be notified of new episodes as I release them. and feel free to reach out if you need anything at all as you move forward with your prep. I'm happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.